I see the reactions to my videos have been very good. Let's talk radiochemistry. We have just spent the last week or two talking about transmutation, and it all seems very arbitrary. How does it happen in real life? There are two answers to that question: nuclear reactions and radioactive decay. We can talk about nuclear reactions later, as in a way they're kind of more complicated. This next sentence will probably make no sense to you yet, and that is okay. Transmutation due to radioactive decay happens when the strong nuclear force is not powerful enough to keep a nucleus together due to proton-neutron imbalances. In order to understand both radioactivity and that sentence, we need to know why atoms decay. All atoms wish to be stable. Stability only happens when there is a correct balance of protons and neutrons. First, we have to learn about the strong nuclear force. Think of it as nuclear glue. If subatomic particles are very, very, very close to each other, they want to stay that way due to that glue. You know how with magnets, similar poles repel each other? The same thing is true with electrical charge. Positive doesn't want to be with positive, and negative does not want to be with negative. If you look inside the nucleus of an atom, you have protons and you have neutrons. Protons have positive charges, while neutrons are neutral. This means that the only particles with charge in the nucleus are protons. In theory, they should try and get away from each other as fast as possible due to their inherent repulsion. This is where the nuclear glue comes into play. Due to neutrons separating the protons, and the fact that all close particles like to stick together, the strong nuclear force is able to keep everything in one clump. Now, if there are too many neutrons, the nucleus will become heavy and unwieldy, and the nuclear glue can no longer do its job. If there are too few neutrons, the protons get too close together, and the electric repulsion starts overpowering the nuclear glue. These two situations are where radioactive decay takes place. There are five major types of radioactive decay. These are called decay modes. There is alpha decay, beta decay, positron emission, electron capture, and gamma emission. Alpha decay is when a nucleus shoots off a helium nucleus. Please note that this is not a full helium atom, it's just the nucleus of one. The original decaying nucleus loses two protons and two neutrons, the components of a helium nucleus. Beta minus decay, often just called beta decay, is when a nucleus shoots off a beta particle, or in common terms, an electron. This happens when a neutron turns into a proton. This means that its atomic number goes up by 1 due to the additional proton, but the atomic weight stays the same because there is still the same amount of particles in the nucleus. Positron emission, or beta plus decay, is when a nucleus shoots off a positron. A positron is just like an electron, except it has a positive electrical charge. This form of decay happens when a proton turns into a neutron. The atomic number drops, but the atomic weight stays the same. Electron capture is when a nucleus is hit by an electron, and that collision forces a proton to turn into a neutron. As a result of this transmutation, an X-ray photon is made and released. The last form of decay, gamma emission, is special. It can only occur after alpha or beta decays have happened. This is due to alpha or beta decay getting a nucleus excited, and the only way it can calm down is by putting out a gamma photon. To summarize all this madness, alpha decay is when a helium nucleus is released. Beta decay is when an electron or positron is released. Electron capture is when an electron turns a proton into a neutron and releases an X-ray. And gamma emission happens to calm down a nucleus, and it releases a gamma photon. Now let's go back to that sentence. Transmutation due to radioactive decay happens when the strong nuclear force is not powerful enough to keep a nucleus together due to proton-neutron imbalances. That makes a little more sense, doesn't it? Thank you for watching this very long episode of whatever this is, and I hope you learned something from this. The end. Yeah, I'm done. Woof. I'm flying.
This is what my room looks like when I'm filming.